off at night.
Thank you.
Wherever we are, it's falling apart. Someone else might be other survivors.
You've come to save us from this place. From this place you'll free us.
The exposed brain quivers in expectation.
Please. Before they return! They return. Remove us. From this body! From this case. Free us.
Brain won't budge.
A newborn. Born new from this husk.
You know no creature like this. One that is more brain than person.
Textura! Textura! Abomination! This is your end!
Your head throbs and your skin tingles. Visions rush past. A dragon's wing, a silver sword, and a flash of your face seen through the strange woman's eyes.
Ugh. My head! What is this? Squaw, you are no thrall. Blackith blesses me this day. Together, we might survive. Imps block the path forward. You will assist me in destroying them. We must reach the helm before we transform. First, we exterminate the imps. Then we find the helm and take control of the ship. We will address the matter of a cure for this infection once we reach the material plane.
hand, won't you, love?
The Mind Flayers have already enthralled.
Psionic energy. Can't read this script. Dazed woman.
Key. For what? We are nearing the helm. Once inside, do as I say.
We need to get out of here, now!
These intruders open! A furnace is ours!
If this ship hits the ground, we're dead.
Before they strike.
Let these intruders open! A furnace is ours!
Forward, Istik, before more.
The Helm's alien transponder. You've made it in time.
Go! can't believe I'm in one piece.
Fresh water. There must be a settlement somewhere nearby. Must have been fishing when these monsters came. Bad luck.
Better stay back. One strike could be lethal.
Can't hold forever. Come on! Blasted door, I... What? Stop! Not another step or I'll... Wait!
You're that drow I saw in the ship. You survived then.
Suddenly, you see what she sees. Feel what she feels. Anger. Confusion. Resolve.
You. You've got the same thing I do. In your head. I felt it.
The same. It must be that tadpole they put in our eyes. I assume that's what caused our minds to... cross.
These things are going to consume us from the inside and turn us into mind flayers.
You and I need a healer. Finding one won't be easy in this wilderness. We'll need supplies.
I'm hoping something of use might be behind this door, but I've barely made a dent in it so far.
Be my guest, but that door's too strong. Maybe there's another way, up the cliff. Hopefully, there's no more of these things.
Well, these things have been giving me plenty of practice. But I'd rather get out of here than push my luck.
Or just company for our final moments. But you're right. Whatever lies ahead will be a little less daunting with support. You can call me Shadowheart. Lead the way.
Ex-tectura!
Harry, I've got one of those brain things cornered. There, in the grass. You can kill it, can't you? Like you killed the others? I was hoping for a kind soul. Well, not to worry. I saw you on the ship, strutting about whilst I was trapped in that pod. What did you and those tentacled freaks do to me? I'm not an idiot. I saw... Ah!
Your mind twists. You're looking out of unfamiliar eyes, prowling dark, busy streets. You try to hold the memory, but it fades to the worm. The light... The fear.
What was that? What's going on? It's those tentacled monsters. Whatever they did to us caused that link. They took you too. I saw it during whatever just happened. And to think, I was ready to decorate the ground with your innards. Apologies. A kindred spirit. My name's Astarion. I was in Baldur's Gate when those beasts snatched me. Is that so? We clearly move in different circles. So, do you know anything about these worms? Turn us into... Of course it'll turn me into a monster. What else did I expect? Although, it hasn't happened yet. If we can find an expert, someone that can control these things, there might still be time. You know, I was ready to go this alone, but maybe sticking with the herd isn't such a bad idea. And you seem like a useful person to know. All right, I accept. Lead on.
Survivors. They're trying to dig somebody out of the wreckage.
Something's wrong.
So much blood.
They should be trying to get away if they had any sense.
Come on, dig! Faster! Get her out of there! Don't die! Don't die! Don't die!
The person they're trying to save, it's the creature from the ship. Still alive. But wounded. Your voice cuts through the fog of confusion. You can see the creature's hold on them wavering. As its influence wanes, they clutch their heads. Blinking in confusion. You approach the dying monster. This is the thing that abducted you. You could end its life here and now. If only you didn't feel compassion. Compassion. Yes, you feel hate, and you deserve to be punished for it. You should be whipped, made to bow before this creature in shame. It's possessing your mind, forcing you to love it. But then, the feeling slips. The creature's mind seems to focus elsewhere. Your mind spews, lusting for something that is gone. But then, its grip claws back with a vengeance, a vice locking your mind into obedience. It needs sustenance to survive, and with your very body, you can provide. Warm, wet tentacles wrap themselves around your head, and for the first time in your life, you're perfectly happy.
Something the matter? We haven't gone all that far yet. What are you referring to exactly?
That's unexpected. Last I saw you, you were lying in a crucible's worth of blood. An intellect devourer nibbling at your ear. Glad to see my eyes deceive me. I'm Gale. Well met. See that rune? Netherese, I think. Weave so thick on it, it's almost viscous. Not to mention, you're staring at me like a Rashimi at a blackboard. You're no wizard, are you? Pity. But that'll have to wait. The primary need now is a healer. I take it you recall the insertion of the parasite? Are you aware that after a period of excruciating gestation, it'll turn us into mind flayers? A process known as seramorphosis? It is to be avoided. I assume you're no accomplished healer, either. Powerful cleric, maybe? I gather as much. We'll have to look for a solution elsewhere. You and I are in a whole lot of trouble. We need help, and I'm not sure where we'll find it in this wilderness. How about we embark on the quest for a healer together? And I'm flattered, I'm sure. But it seems you're traveling with a substantial amount of companions already. Maybe later, yes? Go to hell. Ha! You're a good sport. Go to hell. An everyday expression. So trivial, it's almost meaningless. But we've seen hell. It's real. And it isn't trivial. Devils. Dragons. Mind flayers. They used to be abstracts. Pictures on a piece of paper. What a difference a day makes. Now we have tadpoles slithering through our heads like carnivorous foeti. That's not abstract. That's the spirit. Let's be up with the lark. Find a healer before the wee one gets hungry.
Talk later.
I'm not sure this is a good idea. There are lit fuses in our heads. Sooner or later, they're going to blow. Each hour that passes, the thing inside us grows. We need to find a healer. Let's wake up at first light. Maybe we'll get lucky. We're overdue some good fortune. Rest well. We'll need our strength.
I'm telling you. And the crypt can wait. Mari and Barton have been trying to break in for days. Now we... Stop! Got ourselves competition already. That's our ship. Well, in that case, come on, you lot. No point in getting killed. Second worm gets the cheese and all.
Second mouse gets the cheese, no?
Nobody's getting any damn cheese! Now move it!
You're more cunning than you look. I thought we had a fight on our hands.
Thank you, Gibblebok. Everything all right out there? Think I'm stupid? Don't know who you are or what you've done with the boss.
But if you come through that door, you're getting a knife.
Well, perhaps our survival isn't such a distant prospect.
No more prayers, only dust and silence.
Who are those prayers for? Normally the patron god is obvious. Not here.
Thank you. mortal too unsoon. Take you.
You do not recognize the language on the plaque.
be worth a look. What did that do?
It's loose. One good push away from tumbling.
Have left the plaque unreadable.
tadpole has... But the longer we wait, the more it consumes. My people possess the cure for this infection. I must find a creche. You will join me. It is many things. A hatchery, a training grounds, a shelter. Githyanki protocol is clear. When infected with a Geek tadpole, we must report to a caretaker for purification. You are full up. Dismiss your weakest warrior. The Horned Ones mentioned a camp. One there, this Zoru, has seen Githyanki.
Indulging in a spot of vanity. Handsome devil, aren't I? Be that as it may.
Seramorphosis. What does it make you think of? Spot on. Day one, fever and memory loss. Day two, hallucinations and graying skin. Day three, hair loss and blood leaking from all orifices. Need to go on? Day four, excruciating pain as the skeleton and organs reform and reposition. Day five, the host personality has disappeared. Fingers and toes and limbs elongate. I take it you get the picture? Day six, the flesh around the mouth splits to make way for tentacles. Day seven, a mind flayer is born. This is the annotated version, of course. The storyteller's gift. My point is this. Our orifices remain blissfully unblooded, our heads remain clear, and our blood temperature normal. Any expert will agree, this is abnormal. I'll toast to that. The pragmatic in me, however, sees only the silence before the storm. Something to sleep on. We should get some rest.
The voice on the ship told me I'd become a beautiful weapon. What do you think it meant? Whatever they were, those plans were interrupted by the dragons. Either way, we can't take the lack of symptoms for granted. Well, I've said my piece.